नमस्कार, राजकृष्णा देसाई। लेट्स सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन। सॉल्व 10 पावर x प्लस x माइनस 4 इक्वल्स टू 0 यूजिंग न्यूटन रैप्सन मेथड, करेक्ट टू 3 डेसिमल प्लेसेस। ओके, सो दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट, अप टू हाउ मेनी डेसिमल प्लेसेस एंड व्हाट इज द मेथड विच वी आर यूजिंग। सो इन दिस केस दे हैव मेंशन द न्यूटन रैप्सन मेथड। ओके, सो लेट्स सी व्हाट द फंक्शन इज। Your function in this case is 10 power x plus x minus 4. Fine? Okay. And let's keep derivative also with us. So, derivative of a power x is a power x. And then we have log a. Base is e. Fine. Derivative of x is 1 and the derivative of minus 4 is 0. Okay. So you have this in front of you, 10 power x log 10 to the base. Okay. Solvable. Okay. What will be the value of x? We'll put that and we'll see accordingly. Okay. So fx, f dash x is in front of us. Now let's check for the interval in which it is changing from positive to negative or negative to positive. So if you check for 0, so 10 power 0 is 1 plus 0 is 1 minus 4. So that is minus 3, because 1 minus 4 is minus 3. What about 1? It will be 10 plus 1, 11 minus 4, that is 7. So your root lies between minus 3 and 7. Fine. Let's go a bit more closer to the root. Okay. So let's check for 4 if possible. So f of 4 will be 10 power 4 plus 10. Minus 4, obviously it will be some positive quantity also. What about checking for any smaller number like 2? Okay. By the way, why have checked for 4? This is just a silly thing which I have done. I will have to take further. I'm going out of range. I will have to check for another number between 0 and 1. Okay. So let's check 0.5. So f of 0.5 is, now I have to use my calculators. So 10 power, if I need, so shift log, that log you have to press, then you get 10 power. So 10 power in this case is 0.5. And then you have plus 0.5 and minus of 4. So this is giving me a negative thing. Okay. So still negative. So your root is between, and this value is 0.33. Okay. 7722. Okay. Now still negative. So your root is between 0.5 and 1. Okay. I think better interval. Okay. So your interval, which is not much required after one step in Newton-Raphson method, your interval turns out to be between 0.5 and 1. The only requirement of this interval is to find the value of x naught. And you see, which value, either at 1, the value of function at 1 is 7, value of function at 0.5 is 0.33 with negative obviously, which is closer to 0? You will say 7 is 7 units far from 0, but this one is very very closer to 0, so you will choose x naught as whatever value of x which is closer to 0 in this interval. So better to take 0.5 as your x naught. You would have taken out of 0 and 1 also if you were not interested to further zoom in. So you would have taken 0 because 0 is nearer to the value at 0 is nearer to 0. Okay. Because it is 3 units to the left of 0. Okay. So now let's start our iteration. So your first iteration, what is the iterative formula, by the way, for the Newton-Raphson method? So for your, I'm writing it in short. So for your Newton-Raphson method, your iterative formula is xn plus 1 is xn minus value of function at xn divided by value of derivative at xn. This is your iterative formula for Newton-Raphson method. So let's jump into the iterations. So the first iteration will be your x1. So your first iteration, write it iteration because you would not have to write it much more like a bisection method where it goes more than a dozen times. So for x1, here you will write x0. So x0 value, I am writing start writing 0.5 because it is now we have considered 0.5 minus value of function at 0.5. So that we have already calculated, which is negative of this thing. So negative, negative, positive. Okay, divided by value of derivative at this point. Okay. So now value of derivative, so 10 power 0.3377 and then 2 come down, then beware, it is log base e now, so you have to take ln and inside that it should be 10. Okay, so 10, fine, and plus 1, so plus 1, so this is coming out to be 6.011153. So now let's calculate the overall x1 value, which is 0.5 plus, then we have this 0.337722 and this being divided by 6.011153. So this is coming out to be 0.556183. Let's move into the x2 value or the second iteration. So the second iteration which I have is x2. For that we'll use the first iteration value because xn plus 1. So if you put n as 1, x1 plus 1 will be equal to x1 minus something. So x1 is 0.556183 minus value of function at this point. So you will have shift log again. And 10 power is 0.556183. Fine. And then I have plus 0.556183 minus of 4. So this is coming out to be 0.155193 and this being divided by derivative at this point, so that will be shift log again and 10 power is 0.556183 and then you have that ln 10 and plus 1. So this is 9.287026. I prefer to take all the values so that I get as much accurate value as possible. So 9.287026. Okay. Now calculate the x2 overall value. So that is 0.556183 minus, then I have 0.155193 being divided by 9.287026. So this is coming out to be, x2 is coming out to be 0.539472. So we'd have to take up to 3 decimal places. Now we have reached till 1 decimal places only. So let's move on to the third iteration. You could further decrease the number of iteration as much close as you go initially. So the third iteration is x3 equals to 0.539472 minus. Again, the value of function at this point. So that is 10 power, that is 0.539472 plus 0.539472 minus of 4. So this is 0.002628. And now derivative at this point. So we have derivative 0.539472. This being multiplied by ln 10 and then plus 1. So this is giving me 8.9794210. And let's calculate the overall value. Meanwhile, I will have to also check for my battery, which is 43 at the moment. Okay, so this is 0.539472 minus 0.002628, and down I have 8.974210, and the value I'm getting is okay. Now I have got clear up to 2 decimal places, but I will have to further work upon it because they have asked till 3 decimal places. Okay, so let's move to the fourth iteration for the value of x4. So that will be 0.539179. And then what is the function? I forget it. X power 10 power x plus x minus 4. Okay. 10 power 0.539179 minus of 4. So this is coming out to be negative quantity and 1 minus also, so plus 0.00, how many zeros? 5 zeros, and then a 1, divided by value of derivative at this point. So 10 power x, so again 10 power x is 0.5 3 9179, and then I have into ln 10 plus of 1. So this is 8.968832. Let's do the overall calculation. So this is 0.539179 plus, this is 0.5 times 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, followed by a 1. Then I have down 8.968832. And the overall result is 0.539179. Can I check with the previous value? Yes, I have got that. Because this is clearly matching with the previous one up to three decimal places, 0.539. So after four decimal places, I have got the approximate value of, so the approximate value of the root is x equals to 0.539. correct up to three decimal places, and it took us four iterations to go. So again, I would have taken a lot of time of yours, but if you do it, do the calculation, show the calculation, do it live, then it will certainly take time. Otherwise, I would have done the calculations before and just written you. That would have also been not much of enjoyment. But yes, this is the thing which you have to do yourself. Okay. There's nothing much to teach here, because you know the iterative formula, which is xn plus 1 equals to xn minus. You know where the root lie. That is nothing to do, and then you have to keep on doing the same thing, and this time you have to do it four times till fourth iteration. Then we realized that okay, these are the previous one, and the fourth iteration is matching till three decimal places, and that was the approximate value of our root. So that's it from my side for today. Thanks for watching. For more such problem, you can always visit the playlist on numerical techniques and interpolation. Thanks again.